details of other programmes later on. In between 3 and 4 o'clock, we've got films from the Tonight Programme and Al McCogan, The Girl with a Giggle. Between 5 and 7, we're expecting some rain, particularly when the cricket's on, so the whole schedule could go out of the window until about 8 o'clock, depending, of course, on who's in or out, or indeed weather conditions in general. Moving across to the evening charts, you can see it's quite clear. You've got the Grove family around 7:30-ish. It's very good. I'm looking forward to that. Then the Lime Grove documentary at 9. 10 o'clock, it's Quatermass, which I remember being frightened by as a child, and that programme's going to terrify the whole country, particularly people in Norfolk who would be well advised to hide under a blanket.
And it's Ploughman 3 now coming into the picture. Nothing to choose between them as we go over to the very best of light entertainment in the A to Z of LE.
Now, this celebration programme is not intended in any way at all to be a historical documentary. All we're trying to present to you is an informal reintroduction of some of the people who have helped to make television.
They smile when they are low. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you open and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they hung a star. Let's go on with the show.
I've got a marvellous trick for you. I do hope you like it. It's a little thing with a... Well, it isn't mine, actually. I saw this one on television the other day. I thought it was very clever. The fellow had an ordinary handkerchief, and he put this handkerchief in his right-hand pocket, pushed it into it... You won't believe this, ladies and gentlemen, but I actually saw this happening with my own two pairs of eyes, and I thought it was marvellous. He pushed it into his right-hand pocket, and he just went like this, and it disappeared from his right-hand pocket, and he took it out of his left-hand pocket. It's clever stuff, isn't it? But the best bit was when he put it back in his left-hand pocket and then he just went psst again and it jumped over to his right-hand pocket. Marvellous! Oh, I guessed how he did it. He must have had a hollow body, you know. He must have gone... Well, you couldn't do it any other way. Oh, it tickles.
Have you got the time, please, sir?
Half past.
Well, thank you very much, sir. Can I just borrow your watch?
Just a minute. It's watch there, isn't it?
Now, this is your watch, sir, isn't it?
Of course it is. You know it is. You just took it all from me.
I shall just wrap it up in this handkerchief, sir. Now, I want you to watch your watch. You're watching your watch, are you?
No,
you've got your watch.
It.
Right. Now, have you ever thought of selling your watch, sir?
No.
Right? You haven't thought of selling your watch? Well, it's just about to come under the hammer now, sir. You look worried, sir. I'm worried. If the trick doesn't work, I don't work. Let's see how it does.
Well, that's a fine trick, isn't it?
Go.
The most beautiful sound I have ever heard. Maria, 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 Maria. All the sounds of the earth in a single word. Maria, 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 Maria. Maria, I just kissed a girl named Maria, and suddenly that name will never be the same. Say it soft,
and it's almost like praying. Maria, I'll never stop saying, Maria.
I once had a pain in my chestal area, up here, high above my fabulous hips. And I was convinced that it was heartburn, because I was married at the time, and my wife used to cook for me all the time with those Nazi recipes, you know, I used to have chicken Himmler for dinner every night. And I didn't want to spend $25 to go to the doctor and have it reaffirmed that I had heartburn, because it wasn't worth it. But a friend of mine at that time got a pain in the exact same spot, and I figured if I could get him to go to the doctor, I could figure out what's wrong with me. For nothing. So I talk him into it, and he goes. Costs him $25. He's got heartburn. And I feel fabulous, because I beat the doctor out of $25. And I call my friend 2 days later, and he died. I check into the hospital immediately. You know, I have tests run and x-rays. Cost me $150. I had heartburn. I'm furious now. I run to my friend's mother. And I say, did he suffer much? She says, no, it was quick. A car hit him and that was it.
Right? Angels and ministers of grace, defend us. Be thou a spirit of health or goblin damned. Bring with the airs from heaven or blast from hell. Be thy intents wicked or charitable, thou comest in such unquestionable shape that I will speak to thee.
It's on. It's on. It's not working.
No, it's not. I've got it here.
It's not working.
The mic isn't working?
It's not working.
You mean I've been spouting through the thing and it hasn't been coming? I say, I must have looked silly standing there. I'll get the stage manager to clear. Stage manager! Something seems to have gone wrong with the microphone. I'm terribly sorry.
Nothing to do with me.
No. I didn't say it was, but I mean...
I can't go around looking after measly microphones like that.
No, I didn't ask you to, but I thought maybe...
This is an electrician's job.
Yes, well, could we please have the electrician to sort of tinker with it or...
All right. Hang around, I'll see if I can locate him. Charlie!
How much?
$5.
$5. Take me down to the first floor. Silly boy. I was only joking. Of course you shall have $5. There you are. There it is. That's it. What's for the gag? Thank you. Well, these things go wrong, don't they? It can't be helped. Well, I got out of the hotel and I eluded the house detective. There's a very nice fellow called Opportunity. They call him that because he only knocks once. Hello, is. What a hotel. The walls were so shaky, the termites had to wear parachutes. That's the first good laugh of the evening. God bless you.
What should we play? What would be a good number to play as a duet, huh?
I don't know. How about the Rondo Capriccioso by Saint-Saëns?
I don't know. That's been done to death.
Now, you're going to dance something presently.
Yes.
A ballet dance. Do you like doing ballet at school?
Yes.
Like it?
Yes.
Do
Can you teach anyone to dance?
Yes, sure.
How easy is it?
Come and I'll show you.
Remember Fred Astaire? Set it up, putting on my top hat. Passing up the white tie, brush it off the tail.
Are you going to take it up seriously?
I shouldn't think so.
Aren't you? Why not?
I want to be a writer.
Oh, do you?
Ces jours de feu et de poussière, en face du sommeil accablé de la terre, assourdi par le cri des cigares sans nom, je cherchais votre cœur.
Ask you a question?
Please do.
Right. Well, with a safety match, it's brown in its own right on the head, which, you know, can strike on the ordinary box.
Yes.
Where there's various colours for striking on the rough surface. What's your choosing?
I suppose I like the redheads.
Ah. Oh, yeah. Well, I must say this, that while these matches do their float in the space relay curves, that is top, mid, load and bottom, there's no official striking.
Oh, I see.
Thank you.
joker. It's not a foxtrot or a polka. It has a little bit of new rhythm, a blue rhythm that sighs. It's got a rhythm that is tricky, a bit of wicky wacky wicky. And when you dance it with a new love, there'll be true love in her eyes.
Tony Bennett, he got toilet, toilet, then the toilet twiz. That's how it's gotta feel. Frank songs, you should do a thing, right? Deeper than the deep blue seas. That's how deep it goes. If it's real. Frankie Lane? Well, somebody needs you. It's no good unless you need you. Whoa. Through the good old lean. Come with me. Little Dean, of course. Who knows? Who knows where the road will lead us? Only, only who will say? Me.
Sheila, I'm going to read the question very carefully. The joke carefully, and I want you to study it first before you laugh. Here we go, friends. It's a very pretty dress. I wish we had color television. Is it true that two peanuts were walking across Piccadilly Circus and one was assaulted?
Down the way where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountain top, I took a trip on a sailing ship, and when I reached Jamaica, I made a stop. But I'm sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. Had to leave a little girl in Kingston Town. Down at the market, you can hear ladies cry out while on their heads they bear. Acty rice, salt fish are nice, and the rub is fine any time of year. But I'm sad to say I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. Had to leave a little girl in Kingston Town.
You better lead the way.
A right and a right. And
follow
a left,
this.
And a left and a hop, 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 hop.
All right, Don, take it, man.
For a night out, see? They want to have a bit of a sing-song, don't they? Want to have a lot of song.
What do you think I've been doing for the past quarter of an hour but singing?
Yeah, what I mean, all due respect, I mean, people don't want all that woo-wah, woo-wah stuff all the time, do they?
Some people like...
No, they want something, a bit of a tune to it.
Let's have a while. The jetty to the church. Don't die.
here we go with Calic Calic Go the Shears.
Shears.
Out in the shed, the old shearer stands, grasping his shears in his thin, bony hands. Fixed is his gaze on a bare-bellied yo. Glory if he gets her, won't he make the ringer go? Click, go the shears, boys, click, click, click. Wine is his bow and his hands are prick. The ringer looks around and is beaten by a blow. A curtsy old beggar with the bare-bellied yo.
These works were forgotten. And that song, written over 30 years ago, has never, so far as we know, been sung in this country before tonight. Nor is any part of the rise and fall of the city of Mahagoni.
Don't show us the way to the next whiskey bar. Oh, don't ask why. Oh, don't ask why. For we must find the next whiskey bar. For if we don't find the next whiskey bar, I tell you we must die. I tell you we must die. I tell you, I tell you, I tell you we must die. Oh, moon of Alabama, we now must say goodbye. We've lost our good old mama and must have whiskey, oh, you know why.
Cheers.
Choo-choo to Broadway, ooh, Cincinnati. Donkey-dicky with a 1, 2, 3. Life is just so fine on the solid side of the line. Rip, hold tight, hold tight. Hold tight, hold tight. Brack-a-sack, you want some seafood, mama? Shrimps and rice, they're very nice.
Here they are doing a spot of Strauss.
Thank you.
Could I have the music once again? Thank you. Never mind the light. Angels and ministers of grace defend us. Be thou spirit of health or goblin damned. Bring with the airs from heaven or blast from hell. Be thy intent wicked or charitable, thou comest in such unquestionable shape.
What's the matter now? It's off again.
Well, I haven't touched the thing. State manager! Look, I'm looking a bit ridiculous up here. I'm doing my best. I'm sorry, but the microphone still isn't working. I can't project myself unless I...
You're becoming a bit of a bore. I've got more things to do than dash around and administer to your every whim. You're a bit of a shower, aren't you?
Could I have the electrician? I can talk to him. And if I can have the electrician...
I'll ask him, but I'm sure he'll be absolutely livid. Charles? Charles?
Charlie! Charlie!
I shall have life everlasting, only my Savior has. Joy shall rejoice in the resting, only my Savior has. Free from this world and its soul.
She came to see me off on the station, folks. Isn't that great? Ah, shucks.
Oh, I do wish I was coming with you, though.
Ah, she wishes she was coming with me. Oh, you're too ducky.
Oh, my love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June. Oh, that's sweetly played in tune, as fair a thought
shining on the beach below. The folks are crooning soft and low. You needn't tell me, boy, because I know, yes. when it's sleepy time down south. Yes, the south wind blowing through the pine wood trees. That folks down there live a life of ease. When old mammy falls on her knees, yes. When it's sleepy time down south.
Winter cleaning to earn an honest bob for a nosy parcel. It's an interesting job. Come on, now it's a job that just suits me. A winter cleaning you would be if you can see what I can see when I'm cleaning windows.
And if you go out, when you go out there, I mean, you'll just have so much fun with your wife and your children. I'll have another one, Pete. you'll have such fun. You'll have such a real time. I'm telling you, your wife will love it. Your children will love it, too. Well, cheers. And then... when you feel that you've had a full day out in the open air, I'm telling you, I'll have another one, Pete. Yeah. And you'll feel that you really have really something, you know, that you have. And you'll feel fine. Oh, yeah, here you are. There's the change. Fine. All right. Cheers. Yeah. You'll feel
Hello, where's the fruit? Well, that's about it then.
So now I'd just like to say three little words. Good night, good luck, and God bless.
Get over me! Stop coming here!
It was wonderful. I'm still tasting it.
Thank you very, very much.
Bye.
Good evening. I am glad to have the opportunity to say goodbye to my British publisher.
And that's it, is it? Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.
This is the BBC television service, and I have a few moments in hand to explain to you our brand new logo. As you can see, the wavy lines on the left symbolize the sea, waves, and the wavy lines on the right symbolize other wavy things. The circles in the middle are, in fact, an aerial view of a Mexican hat.
People. Being a copper, you see some strange things. I mean, take the phone box. Used to stand behind me here. Disappeared one day, nicked by a bloke called Doctor Who. Quite annoying, really, and me sandwiches in it. Understand this Doctor Who's played by an actor called William Hartnell. Sounds like a dress designer to me. Still, takes all sorts.